And this next one, very close category to Mike's and my heart, Category 11, British Bitter. Matthew Rushman, non-affiliated, Best Bitter Bronze Medal.
Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Matt. And today I want to talk about homebrewing competitions. I recently entered in 2 homebrewing competitions for the first time ever, and I want to talk about the competitions that I entered, what beers I submitted in those competitions, and how the beers were judged. I also want to talk about the general notes I got from my submissions, and also talk about my overall thoughts and experiences. Before we get started, I want to mention that I might be looking down a lot in this video, and that's just because I'm reading directly from the notes that the judges gave me on the feedback section, and also I took some general notes for this video. The first thing I want to talk about is what competitions I entered. I entered in the Michigan State Fair. I submitted 4 beers in that, and then I entered in the Michigan Beer Cup, and I only submitted 1 in that. The Michigan State Fair allowed 5 submissions, and the Michigan Beer Cup allowed 1 submission. For the Michigan Beer Cup, I entered my best bitter, and for the Michigan State Fair, I entered my best bitter, my Baltic Porter Lager, my New England IPA, and my Black IPA. Both competitions were BJCP sanctioned. Also, I want to mention, all 4 of these recipes will be down in the information section below. I created grain to glass videos on all 4 of these, so you can see my recipe, my overall brew day, and then my tasting notes at the end of each video. Along with entering these competitions and seeing if I'd win anything, I also wanted to test some things. Number 1, I wanted to test the scoring integrity between different competitions. So that's really the main reason why I submitted my best bitter in two separate competitions, because if you think about it, you should get close to the same score with both competitions if there is a lot of scoring integrity with the BJCP judging program. The other thing I wanted to try doing is I wanted to try to submit my Black IPA recipe and submit it in a different style, like the American Stout. There's 2 main reasons why I chose the American Stout. The first reason was, and if you look at my grain of glass video, you'll also see this, is I didn't think it was very bitter, and I thought it could probably pass as an American Stout. And also in Beersmith 3, there is BJCP style guides, and the Black IPA recipe also fit the same style guide as the American Stout. So I wanted to try to submit my Black IPA as an American Stout to see how the judges would react. So for both of these competitions, they were actually scored very differently. In the Michigan State Fair, there was a gold, a silver, and a bronze in each category. So that means if there's only 3 submissions in that category, you're guaranteed a medal because they have to give a gold, a silver, and a bronze medal in each category. The Michigan Beer Cup, there is no guarantee of a gold, silver, or bronze medal. It's entirely based on your score. If you score a 35 and up, you win a medal for that day. The last thing I want to talk about before we get into the judges' notes on these 4 beers that I submitted is I want to talk about what the scoring means. So a 0 to 13 score means that there's major off flavors and it's difficult to drink. A 14 to 20 means that there is off flavors or major style defects. From 21 to 29, you simply miss the mark on the style. From 30 to 37, you are within style parameters. From 38 to 44, it exemplifies the style well. And lastly, from 45 to 50, it is a world-class example of the style. So now we can jump into what kind of scoring I got from these 4 submissions and what kind of feedback I got from these 4 submissions. So I averaged out the scores, and for the Michigan Beer Cup, my best bidder received a 35.3. For the Michigan State Fair, my best bidder received a 34. My Baltic Porter Lager averaged a 34. My New England IPA averaged a 31.5. And my Black IPA, submitted as an American Stout, averaged 24.5. So I want to go through each submission and talk about the positive notes I got from the judges and the negative notes I got from the judges. So first of all, talking about my best bitter, the positive notes were it's a good drinking beer, decent body, good example of the style, and hits the marks pretty well. The negative notes are lacking bitterness, lacking complex malt aroma and flavor, hop flavor needs to be more assertive, lacking flavor, esters are pushing boundaries, malt aroma is a bit intense, and bump up hop characteristics. So the only thing I want to mention when looking at the negative notes is there is a contradiction in the notes between judges. One judge thought that my beer was lacking complex malt aroma and flavor, while another judge thought my malt aroma was a bit intense. So I thought that was kind of interesting. For my Baltic Porter, my positive notes were matches style pretty well and starts bright and has a nice dark fruit toffee flavors. The negative notes are dark malts are too dominating and finishes too roasty and dry. Next is my New England IPA. The positive notes were hop aromas are good and well balanced and smooth. The negative notes were bitterness is too high, oxidation, hop flavors are lacking, and need to increase hop flavor additions. The only thing I want to mention for the negative notes was regarding the bitterness was too high, there were no bittering additions for this batch. In fact, all the hops that were added for this was, I believe, a 15-minute whirlpool, so I don't really know how I could make this beer any less bitter, considering that there were no bittering additions. And my last thing I want to talk about is my Black IPA that was submitted as an American Stout. My positive notes were, hop aromas are pleasant, and my negative notes are, hops need to be backed off, not to style, does not smell or taste like an American Stout. That's exactly what I would think I would receive since I submitted a Black IPA as an American Stout. I thought the hop flavors were not very strong, but the judges did pick out that this is probably a Black IPA considering the hops need to be backed up. They also mentioned that this is just not to style and this does not taste like an American Stout, which makes sense because it isn't an American Stout. Lastly, I want to talk about my overall impressions of submitting in a BJCP sanctioned competition. And that's to first talk about their scoring integrity. And I want to say I'm actually pretty impressed. I submitted the Black IPA as an American Stout, and they were able to figure that out pretty quickly with sampling the beer. Another thing is I submitted the same beer in two different competitions, and it was only 1 point off from both competitions. Now I want to mention that there are only two data points to this problem, and maybe if you submitted the same beer into more competitions than two, maybe you would see something different. Who knows? But at least for these two examples that I did, there was only 1 point off, so I'm actually pretty impressed with their scoring. Regarding judge scoring, I have 3 points that I want to mention. And the first thing is there is one judge that just did not give me a lot of feedback. And mind you that this is an outlier considering all of the other judges gave me, I would say, decent feedback, some better than others. But there was one judge in particular who just gave me 1, 2, or 3 word answers on each column. I did not find that very useful or helpful, so I don't know how often there are judges who give you such little information, but I did want to mention that there was a judge in two of these competitions that just did not give me a whole lot of feedback on my submission. The second thing I want to mention is that there are some columns that the judges filled out that only gave me positive feedback, but they did not score me very high. So again, that feedback isn't very useful for a homebrewer, because there's nothing for me to go off of. If the column says it's a great beer and it smells like it should and it tastes like it should, but then they score me a 5 out of 10, then I don't really know what to work with within that feedback. The last thing I want to mention is that there were a few judges that did not fill out the whole form completely. I don't know if there's optional fields in the form or not. It doesn't seem like there are. Maybe they were busy, maybe they forgot. There was about 3 or 4 judges that did not fill out this section, so I did want to make a note of that. Lastly, regarding my overall general experience, I had a lot of fun with this. It was fun submitting for competition. I think I'm definitely going to do it again. I did win a medal, which was cool. I wasn't really expecting to win considering that this was my first competition, and it was good to see a lot of solid feedback on my beers. Getting feedback from family and friends can be difficult. They might not want to hurt your feelings, or maybe they just don't know a whole lot about the beer or the style you're serving them. So it's good to get professional feedback every now and then to make sure that your process is good. Also, if there's maybe any off flavors that you're generating in your homebrewing process, like diacetyl or oxidation, maybe a judge will be able to point it out and you can start to tighten up those processes. But that about covers it, talking about homebrewing competitions. Like I said, I had a lot of fun and I plan on doing this again. If you liked the video, make sure to like and subscribe to the YouTube channel, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks, guys.